The spray mop attachment is incredible, you guys. So when I first got my Norwex mop, the only thing that I was thinking that could have made this mop any better was a water reservoir, so I didn't have to continue to get my mop pad wet. You know, every once in a while when I'm mopping, I notice it dries out, I have to take it off, gotta run it on the water, wring it back out. Anybody that has a mop already is going to be able to use this. This is one of the greatest features about this. If you already have the Norwex mop, you are not gonna have to buy an entire new system. I think that was one of the smartest things that Norwex could have done. They're always thinking so smart. They're thinking about better ways for us to be able to be, you know, more sustainable. And this was definitely it. So I'm gonna show you how to attach this. Also show you how you're gonna add your water, okay? So this is the water reservoir. It comes right off. You're gonna unscrew this little thing here and you're gonna add your water to it. Now here in a little bit, I'll talk a little bit about other things that you might be able to add to it. I have water in mine right now and that's all I normally use. Every once in a while, I might add something else. So once you've added your water, you just pop this sucker right in there, okay? Now, on your mop base, you're going to take this part off right here. Comes off really easy. Then you're gonna take your attachment, okay? You're gonna take this part, see where I got it? And you're gonna attach it to your mop base and it clicks right in. You pop that sucker right in there. And then the top goes right in as well. You can use it on the large mop system or the small one. And it clicks right together. You wanna make sure it clicks because if it didn't click, then you don't have it all the way in there and then you might have a mess, okay? If you have it at an angle, it's not gonna spray properly. You wanna hold it straight up, press it down. That's another groovy thing. No batteries. How awesome is that? Manual, right? So you press down to spray the water, then you're able to mop and go for as long as you want. When you need to re-wet it, you do it again. Now, if you're using the wet mop pad, it's not a big deal if you get water on the floor. But if you switch this mop pad and maybe you're using the dry one, you wanna always make sure that you're mopping at an angle. That way you don't, if you're dry mopping and just dusting, you don't wanna release water. So you wanna make sure you're mopping at an angle, okay? So another great feature is, of course, the telescopic pull. Look how big that sucker gets. That's amazing. You just twist it and tighten it right back up. I'm a little bit shorter, so I don't need it real tall. So let's talk about some other reasons why this is amazing. So now, that reservoir right there is gonna hold, what is it? 8.5 ounces or 250 milliliters of water. That's a lot of water. That's gonna be 160 sprays. So you're not really gonna have to. Do I have to log back out? Do you hear me? Do you guys hear me? I'm hoping you guys hear me. Let me know. Hi guys, hi from Florida, hi Joanne. So it holds 250 milliliters of water. That's up to 160 sprays. That's huge. So the reason I only use water is because our mop pads are so amazing. You really, it's gonna remove 99.9% of bacteria and dirt and debris with just the pad. Now, if I need a little bit more oomph, I might use some Ultra Power Plus, but here's the thing. If you're gonna leave it in there, you only wanna leave water in there. If you put Ultra Power Plus in there or anything else, and I'm not gonna suggest anything else, I'm just saying, if you do, for one, you don't wanna void your warranty. And if it's other than water and you're leaving it in there, you could possibly void your warranty. So don't do that. If you do dilute Ultra Power Plus, which would be okay to do, you want to make sure that you use it and you empty it out. Don't leave it in there. It could clog it up and it might not work properly. So the only thing that you can leave, right, that's right, Amy. The only thing that you can leave in there is water, okay? So let's talk about some other things that I used to use on my floors. One of which, and I want to show you this difference. So I'm not allowed to name product names, but I'm sure just by seeing this, you guys know what this is, okay? I want to show you the difference. This is Norwex's small superior mop system. This is the small one, and look at the size difference. It's still bigger than the one everybody used to use, right? Now, this is just the normal one. I keep this in my closet for demos on what not to use, all right? So let's talk about this. Now, this one also comes in a wet sprayer, what they call the wet jet, right? So let's talk about some of the things in the wet jet. For one, the pads, if an animal was to eat those pads, it's gonna cause gastrointestinal blockage if it's eaten. So if it's drank, or like my animals, bigger is better. You're exactly right. If they're like my animals, and my animals literally lick everything, or if I toss a treat on the floor, they're gonna eat it and they're gonna lick up the crumbs, right? So the wet jet, the solution, it's got 9 ingredients, 2 of which are toxic. You got polypropylene glycol and butyl ether. That one's a little bit lower on the toxicity level, but there's one that's super toxic, and it's called dicel dimethyl ammonium chloride. And if that one's ingested by animals or even babies or children, you know, older children, that's really going to be harmful for them. So I read in animals, just in animals, it can cause vomiting, diarrhea, excessive salivation like drooling or foaming, tremors, seizures, and the list honestly goes on. And you can imagine what that's going to do to your children, right? So not only did I used to use those pads and the liquid solution that went in it, but I also used to use this on my floor. So, you know, we got, some of the stuff might work, but what they're doing is leaving all that harmful and toxic residues behind. And on the back of this, a lot of people don't read. If you use stuff like this, then you're supposed to rinse that particular surface with water afterwards. So if anybody's ever mopped with this before, who goes over it and rinses afterwards? Not many people I know. And if you're not, then you're not using it properly, because it says it right on the box, right on the back, that it's really harmful if you don't. So yes, you're supposed to, exactly. And if it doesn't stay wet long enough, you're not completely disinfecting it. So it has to stay wet for like 4 minutes. You know, nobody does that, ever. Even with the antibacterial wipes, I never left that surface wet for 4 minutes because I didn't know. Now I know. I think Min and Amy always say, when you know better, you do better. All right, so there's another product that a lot of people use. Oh, by the way, the wet jet, which I'm not allowed to say the real name, that got between, depending on what solution you would put in there, between a C and a D on the EWG Guide to Healthy Living. So let's talk about another one. This one begins with a B, ends with an A, and rhymes with Ona. Okay? So this is not, it's the hardwood floor cleaner, and it's a cheap, thin finish that you apply to your floors, right? Well, what happens is after repeated use, the film gets thicker and thicker, and then it scuffs and scratches easily, making floors look horrible, right? So now, that got an F on the EWG Guide to Healthy Cleaning. So the ingredients in that floor cleaner, such as bromo nitropropane dial. It raises a health concern because it was suspected of causing gastrointestinal or liver toxicity. That's horrible. These products, I'm telling you, these companies do not have our best interests at heart. And I mean, I guess I get it. They're all about making a buck. They don't know us. They don't care about us. But if we can do better, we need to. You know, it's not even if it's not for ourselves, it's our children, our families deserve it. You know, I've been using these products for years, and I'm so glad I found Norwex because I know it's going to make a difference. I might not see a huge difference. I do see a difference in my allergies, but I know in the long term it's going to make a huge difference. I know you've heard all about body burden and endocrine disruptors from Amy, and it's real. It's real stuff. So I have a surprise for you guys. All right. Before I do that, I want to talk about one more quick thing. I want to talk about all these amazing attachments. Okay. So let me grab. So here's all three of the mops that they had available. All three of them. All these different attachments are going to work on anything. You got your rubber broom. They're going to work on all three of the poles, no matter which one you have. This is the window cleaner. It's got a handle, but this handle also pops off and it attaches to the mop pole. Amazing, right? This also does as well. Oh my God, those nooks and crannies and ceilings when we're short, we can't get to. This thing has been amazing. How bendy it is, it goes right over my ceiling fans. Look at that, that's amazing right there. It doesn't get any better. It's got a handle on it too, but you can pop it off and put it right on your telescopic mop pole. It's amazing. Norwex thought of it all. And the same with, if you get the handheld cleaning system, you basically have a small mop system. Pop that baby right on your pole and you got a small mop. Amazing, right? All right, let's get to the fun part, all right? So I hope everybody has their dancing shoes on. I am a ballroom dancer. I teach ballroom and Latin for a living. That's why you're in my studio right now. And one of the main reasons that I absolutely loved our mop system, especially the spray mop attachment, is because a lot of my students dance barefooted. And I do too, especially if I'm out here and I'm doing yoga or something like that. A lot of people don't like to wear shoes, so they come barefooted. I don't want them to have to worry about soaking in and absorbing chemicals that have been on my floor. So I know that anything that gets brought in, I'm cleaning and I'm getting it off with my mop, but I'm also doing it chemical free. So when people come in, they can rest assured that they're not going to absorb chemicals from my hardwood floor when they are dancing barefoot.